battle continues.
It is a pleasure to introduce Ida. Welcome to the Pleasure Dome, Louis Tomlinson. Those guilty feet have got no rhythm, Mr. Simon Carr. Lovely, 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 lovely. Okay. The acts perform.
Lovely people, and that is a great way to open the show. So much energy, so much performance. My only note, I have one. Shut up before you start. My only note, I want to hear more of the harmonies in general, because what I was drawn to with you guys is the vocal ability. And it's great to see you put on a show like that, absolutely, but vocally I want to hear just a little bit more. That's all I'm saying.
Listen, yeah.
We don't have agents in England.
It's a sad, sad situation.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm speechless. That's an absolutely unbelievable delivery on that vocal. Unbelievable. What's undoubtable is you're a great singer, but actually that performance had more than vocal. It had fight in there and it had passion, and I really felt that from you. It was a great, great song. Well done, well done.
And you just, I don't know. Unbelievable.
You are so important, Shan. Whatever. Please put your...
Good evening. Welcome back to the X Factor Live Finals, everyone. Our theme tonight's Guilty Pleasures, the first of Ida's overs, and a singer from Bradford / Benidorm, who was a hero last week in more ways than once, Danny Tetley.
Danny, look, I know...
Yeah, Danny, you know, I think you're an amazing guy. You're a lovely guy. I see a lot of you around, and you're really, really lovely you are. I'm not 100% sure that was the right song for you. I do think you still got enough room to show off and show what you're capable of. It was when you came off the stool that I really started to feel the passion in the fight. But before then, I was a little bored before the high notes, but I think you'll be all right, Danny.
Obviously, the whole panel took their grumpy pills today.
Bruno, this is what he does.
We're just saying,
Come on, that's crazy for you, Danny. He's the Irish plumber who...
How do you feel about Simon's comment? Yeah.
Simon's comment, push, that I needed to make sure that...
Push yourself, test yourself, and go outside of your comfort zone a little bit. If you're prepared...
I want it to feel like you're not going to do exactly the same performance every time, you know what I mean? So there's got to be a little bit of risk in there.
Well, I know that I'll get through it.
Brennan, I know. Listen, I just want to see that you took a risk. Well done.
It's like, okay, yeah. I've got it. I don't need the dressing. That's just it was better than last week.
Brendan, you know, I think what some people don't realise is, you know, when you get, you know, bad comments, they really do consume you throughout the week. And actually, I've been so, so impressed with you this week. You've come back with fire in your belly. You really want to better yourself as a performer, and I absolutely think you did that with that performance. Well done, mate.
Thank you. Up next is Robbie's Groups again, and two souls whose intentions are good. Oh, Lord, please do let them be misunderstood. It's missing.
You're exactly what I need. Nowhere I'd rather be. Do you wanna get closer? If you've never been to heaven, let me show you. I'ma love you all over.
Listen, I just loved it.
Yeah, guys, it's an amazing performance, great creative in general. It's nice that you bring performance every single week. It's just a personal thing. In general, the fact that the audience were at their most excited was the dance break, I think, is scary in a vocal competition. But it's a personal taste.
Interesting. Guys.
Little do you know I'm trying to pick my...
Yeah, Molly, I know it's difficult having your song changed last minute. Simon, sit down, stop clapping. Let's speak just for a second. I'm not sure actually it was the right song for you. And let me justify that. I don't think you got a chance to really show off your vocal. I think I saw a different side to you in that performance. There was a bit more fight and there was a bit more passion, and I liked that. I could feel how important this is for you. But I'm not 100% sure that we got to see everything you're capable of within that song. That's all I'm going
to
say.
I have to agree with Lou. Now, how that's a guilty pleasure. I don't think I've ever even heard of that song.
I haven't.
But,
Could you possibly...
Molly... I love the song. And she couldn't talk. You did great, Molly.
X Factor Live Finals. Next, it's next one of Louis' boys now, who might be a long way from home, but has no intention returning there anytime soon. It's Dalton.
For this week, I'm singing Whitney Houston.
But a song like this is raising the bar. This is definitely a risk in a great way.
It just sunk in that I'm doing Whitney. Oi, oi, oi.
Can't run from myself. There's nowhere to hide myself.
Be that moment. That, did I choose the song?
No, you did not choose the song. No.
Dalton, as far as I'm concerned, you are on your own league. You are in your own league vocally in this competition. It's almost entertaining for me that I give you a bigger challenge every single week and you raise the bar every single week. You should be very, very proud of yourself. And let me also say, I've not heard a reaction like this in the room. That's you. That's you, Dalton. Yeah, Scarlett, out of a lot of the contestants, for whatever reason, I'm drawn to you. You're a very, very, very likeable person. That vocal that you just delivered there was absolutely amazing. You should be really, really proud of yourself.
Thank you.
Simon clearly likes starting with a cappella. It's a very brave thing to do, so I must say, well done, well
Thank
done,
you
darling,
so
well
much.
Done.
Pleasure, full stop, to listen to you. Well done. Let
your own acts, that's good.
Yeah. Where are the guilty pleasures? I feel like I did
More
not.
More guidelines. We are.
When's your grime album coming out, Robbie Williams?
Yeah, last week felt like a bit of a departure from who you were going to be as artists, but this week is exactly what I was asking for. A bit more street, a bit more fun. Honestly, overall, it was a brilliant, brilliant performance, and actually nice to hear your vocals at the start of it. You sounded great, you've done great. Well done, girls. Well done.
Trust me, Daddy. Thing is, needs a pop star.
Tell me, baby, cause I need to give you a...
Well, look, I mean, it was so nutty, so mental.
Yeah, Gio, you definitely embraced the theme. You definitely embraced the theme. And it goes without saying, you know, you're a lovely guy. The most polite guy maybe I've ever met, actually.
Thank you.
It was just one step too intense and too weird for me. I understand you did an original version of the song. I appreciate that. But it was just a bit too mental for me in general, to be honest,
Just trying to be in the moment, you know? Thank you.
Well, I suppose I'm still learning.
Is it me?
Real men wear...
In the room there.
I know.
They loved it.
I know.
Gio, that was
Really just trying to.
It's a bit out of you, that.
Taking the mick out of me again.
Next week, if you get through, fingers crossed, at least just give me a little cuddle, you know what I mean? Forgotten about me as soon as he got through, you know what I mean?
Cards for you, bro. I'm sick. Hard, and we'd always have that on the motorway.
You, like me, carry yourself with a lot of honesty. Just be confident in you doing you.
Then believe what I think.
Can't stop now, cos I've travelled so far. I know you can, she can pay.
Well done, Louis, on getting the theme right, at least. Simon Cowell. Anyway, you just bossed that. Is that okay? Was that okay?
Anthony, I love Tool, and just to see you...
Anthony, you have a different kind of energy to any other contestant. The way you walk about the stage, the way you walk about your performance is in such an honest way, but such an endearing way. You act in such a way that when if I was watching from home, I would really, really want to vote for you. I thought it was a great, great performance. I want everyone in Liverpool to get behind you. You've done an incredible job. You've done me proud, you've done yourself proud. Well done, lad, well done.
You know, just...
I can understand where Simon's coming from. The song choice didn't feel like you guys. It didn't feel like you really believed it when you performed. I've kind of got a similar note from last week. The chemistry in that moment, you're enjoying this moment together. And I don't get enough of that from you. It's kind of five individual performances right now. I feel like you need to really, really think about your song choices if you get through to next week.
I think it's funny that Robbie picked Party in the USA, considering none of his songs have ever been played at any parties in the USA. up in the...
OK, lads, we've got work to do.
Bella, I absolutely believe you have what it takes to be an artist outside of this show. You have a very, very strong identity, and we've felt that last week and this week. My only note would be I'm not 100% sure what the moody guys with shades are doing behind you. I find it a little bit distracting at times, to be honest. Just in general, I thought it wasn't the perfect song for you. I thought it was a good song. I don't think it was a great song.
Do you know, Bella?
I'm sure if learning...
Look, Bella, first of all, I want...
After the next act.
Yeah, Janice, I'm going to keep it short and sweet. I thought it was the right song for you. I thought it was the right delivery. It was a great vocal. I found the creative a little bit cringe, I'm not going to lie. It didn't really resonate with me. I didn't feel believable when you were doing it. I do think it was the right song, but it was the wrong creative.
At all. So we wouldn't get it.
Subscribe to this channel.